In 2019, Robert finds something truly remarkable.
See the cracks already forming? Look at that. So we're gonna have to really monitor that before we glue it, because this is getting vulnerable now.
An almost complete creature. After 66 million years, finding anything intact is extremely rare.
Matrix cloth, get the consolidant, and to get this block out, we're freezing it.
To keep the fossil in one piece as they remove it from the crumbly layer, the team decides to use a potentially tricky technique. They've covered the fossil in plaster to protect it.
Steady.
Freeing it means they have to flash freeze the crumbly rock surrounding it. Using liquid nitrogen at around minus 300 degrees Fahrenheit.
Watch your footing. Lauren, I'm worried about brittleness here. Get that hammer.
Yep.
Give this a couple whacks with the hammer. Okay. Move over 5 centimeters. Good. It's cracked loose. Yep.
Okay, it's loose.
So we have to get this out in one piece. One, two, three.
Yeehaw!
Total success.
Total success.
This is a technique used in archaeology for digging up human remains. We've got enough time to work with the fossil and not damage it. And I couldn't be happier.
And the creature Robert and his team have found, a turtle. This is the fossil. Now it's been cleaned up. It's lying on its side. Here's the outline of its shell. The shape of the shell and the scalloped edges here tell us that this was a baenid turtle. This baenid turtle would have looked very similar to modern Kuto turtles and lived in the same sort of freshwater environments.
The Late Cretaceous period is kind of the heyday of turtles in at least northern North America. There were at least 16 species that were known from Saskatchewan. And compare that to today, we only have 3. So back then, it was a much better time to be a turtle.